viewers, we are doing another abandoned house. We've done a lot actually in the last like 4 months, but I won't lie, this house is the best abandoned house I've done, I think, maybe this year. I say, oh, this is the best abandoned place I've ever done. I keep saying it because I always keep upping it. I will say though, this house has some like, definitely some like European vibes, almost as if they came from Europe and they started buying some of their things from Europe overseas here. You're gonna see when we go to it. This house is a time capsule. Everything is still inside this house. It's moved around a lot, but it's still amazing. The history about this place is that it was built in 1915, and the owner actually ended up dying in 1987. But the guy was a farmer, and he was a politician. He ended up doing 12 terms being a politician, and then he became the vice chairman. But that's when he died in 1987. The house has been abandoned since 1987. He had a wife, and I don't know too much on his wife or his kids. There's really nothing else on it. It was just about him. But I will tell you guys, like I said, we're going to go explore it right now. Let's get right up into it. But trust me, this is one of the best abandoned houses I've seen. It's super old. It's a time capsule. Let's check it out. Now, before we show the inside of the house, I want to show you guys the outside really quick. First off, again, house is like 1915. So you can tell it's, you know, well over 100 years old right now. And you can see this tree is just so overgrown. It just covers the whole house. It's actually pretty funny. I mean, look at this whole lawn. Nothing's been mowed. Nothing's been kept up. This place is just forgotten about. It is hidden. Nothing too fancy on the outside. What I like about houses is you can look at the outside, see how spooky it might look. Sometimes abandoned houses look really, really cool. This one doesn't look on the outside as cool as some of the best ones I've seen on the outside. But sometimes you go to a house like this and it's like, oh, the outside doesn't look that cool. But then when you go on the inside of this house that doesn't look that cool on the outside, it looks amazing. And then there's houses that you go to where the outside looks great, but the inside doesn't. Pretty much, explorers, what I'm trying to say is you never know what you're going to find in abandoned houses. That's what's cool about it. All right, so to give you this house tour, I want to start off right at the entrance I'm getting in. The whole back of this house is kind of like falling apart. I mean, this thing's dangling and it kind of looks scary. I'm going to hop in here right now. Oh, God. Okay. So we're going to start off this house tour inside the kitchen. And it gets better and better and better as we go. You can tell this house is just beyond old though. I mean, it's not high ceilings. You can almost touch the top with your fingers. People were generally just, shorter back in the day. I don't think that's why this house is just like that. They were just always just built kind of just small with small rooms. I mean, they have a safe in there. God knows what is in that safe right now. Anything. There could be gold bars in there. I really don't know. Still intact. The heater. The fridge down there. Those 1950 fridges we were talking about. Those red show style ones. I really like. This guy had it. I don't know what's in here. Whoa, just like his, like, cubby storage area. I like looking at all these stuff because if you go to like antique shops, you see all these jars you can buy. They're like, you know, like $3, $4, $5 a jar. I almost think like, where does antique people like get their stuff? I guess from like other people and they buy it from them. I mean, we still have his coat in his little closet here. You know, I'm with Seth and with Casey. I'm with my friend Beth. You guys have been seeing them in our videos lately. See, this room, it's like, oh, you wouldn't think like, oh, this is like, you know, a great spot maybe by the first two. The kitchen's promising. But as you go further, you'll see that it's like really good. Fact is, look at this piano. The reason why all these pianos are always in abandoned houses is because you physically can't move them. It will cost a lot of money to move them out. Nobody wants to move a piano out. Once it's in a house, it usually stays in a house. Let's try it though. Does it work? Oh, it does. Oh man, dude, come on, like, just come on. Look how good this is. It's just a perfect house. I mean, look at that TV. This must have been right when color TVs were coming out because it even says on it, colored TV. Like they have to advertise it's in color because it's just that, like they're so used to black and white TVs that they had to advertise it's in color. Creepy dolls.
What the heck? I didn't even notice it was an axe on the couch. I don't know. I was looking at the TV. Admiring the TV. Okay. Yeah, guys, look at this. These old school rackets. I just started playing tennis. Like, imagine going to tennis courts with this.
This?
Oh, wow.
Old school.
No, wait, so rate this place. You've been to a lot of houses that were abandoned. What do you think of this one?
This is like a 9.
Yeah.
This is very good. It's because this is a time capsule. Like, we are literally in a time capsule.
It's so true. I mean, all the old, like, boxes we're looking through. Everyone's looking through the notes, trying to find stuff. Casey, what'd you find?
First, look at all of these.
Hydrogen peroxide. Ascriptin? I don't know what that is. What are these? Like, this gotta be Advil? It's gotta be, like, old, like, Tylenol kind of pills.
Take one.
No.
But then this. So this is a baby picture?
Yeah.
But look at the date.
I can't even see the date.
1895. That's insane.
And that's still here. Dude, that's pictures over 100 years old in your hand. That's wild.
1895?
That's 1,000. Wait, no, it's... Yo, in the video!
Keep that in the video. We're keeping that in. Thanks, you.
In the video.
Look, I dropped out of college.
It's all good. It's all good. It happens. But we out here exploring. We're having a good time. Anyways... I mean, the pencil sharpener's there. Like, what's good?
It's still filled, too.
Yeah, this is the office. It's hot spot.
Yeah, I got something
for you. Wait, hang on. Look at this. Old typewriters down there. We could be looking through here all day for cool stuff.
That guy.
Marlon Brando. He's a famous actor from the 50s.
Well, there's his Life magazine.
Oh, a graduation picture.
Oh.
That's creepy.
Maybe this was his wife. Who knows?
Not Connie Curry.
Because I don't know anything about his wife. Cornell University from 1916. Dude, look how that looks. Ew. That's wild. Hey, that's someone doing some good photographs, though.
What is that?
Probably a map of the campus. So, above the fireplace, we have 3-in-1 oil. I don't know what half these are. 3 drops in nostrils 4 times daily. I don't even know what kind of medicine you would need to even do that. Things are different, too. Like, stuff done then is different now. Oil of cloves.
So, like I said, explorers... Already starting this off, we have some crazy stuff around us. I'm gonna get a picture for this. This might be going on the website. This is so cool. Like, this is great. Let's keep it going and see what else we can find.
You guys know the extent of this place. I think that's all the first floor. Let's check to make sure before we go up. Okay, there's this floor. That's Casey down there. Okay, I guess we can go up. There's a basement. Oh, nope. I just seen a spider cricket. All right, if there's anything down there, let me know.
Oh my gosh.
What does that mean?
There's a dead button. No, I'm just
kidding. Oh my god, dude.
There's really nothing.
There's nothing? No. Okay.
Hey!
Well, this is how you would come in. This is the main door of the actual house. Showing you guys it. It usually always looks like these old houses. It's always an upstairs, and there's always just an alleyway that brings you somewhere. What is in this one? Doorknob's broken. Hang on, what's over there? Sometimes you can miss stuff. Oh. The door that was there got... covered. All right, I'm going upstairs now. I hear Seth up here snooping around.
Yerp. What it do, blood?
Dude, what are you looking at?
I'm just going through the drawers and I just saw a bug on the curtain.
Bro, Who needs the bug? Look at this.
Facts.
Look at this. This is, come on, this is one of the best set up old rooms ever. Ever. For real though. I'm like in the walls, this green tint. Damn. What did this guy, what was he doing? What is this? Wonder how good those smells. Medicated face wash. Got some polish remover. Old school mirrors. These books actually look really cool. At this point, that could even be the owner. I don't know. Just a lot of cool little bottles that I'm interested in. I have no idea what half of them are.
Look how, like, I feel really claustrophobic in this room. Like, I feel just like there's no airflow. I'm tight, it's small. I feel like I'm in a cave right now.
So far, this is my favorite room, hands down, guys. Maybe it is actually the best setup room here for sure. This is insane. Bedroom number one cleared, moving on to bedroom two. Already coming in here, it's a lot more messier than the last one. Different colored wallpaper. Dude, that bed is completely destroyed. What is going on with this bed? I heard on reviews and by multiple people that there was vultures that would live in here, and they guarded this room to death. They didn't want no one here. And I think the vultures is why the room looks so freaking messy. The vultures, like, destroyed it. I've never seen a dresser like this. I'm just paying attention to all the old, like, furniture and things. And look how it was. Just super small, basic, and to cover it, it's just some, like, flimsy little curtain doors. I think anyone that was born around this time would probably really appreciate this house and like this video. There's a barrel just chilling on that desk for whatever reason. Alright. Let's see what's good in here. Dang, this is a really small room. It's like they hid someone in here. Hey, they had a kid. In here. Oh, whoa, it keeps going. What the heck? It goes further down. This house is bigger than I thought. Let's check this out, but hang on, now I'm like tripped out. What's it? Is there anything else here? All right, that's the attic. We'll save that. We're going on a secret mission. Oh, how did I miss this? Well, I didn't miss it, I just never noticed it. Look, we're going to another part of the house. Who would stay in this side? It's not even as nice looking as the other side. Maybe this was the storage part. Maybe it was for servants. I don't know.
Okay, dude, this room is just like kept in the dark.
What's this? Just some random small, like, smaller than a twin bed, it looks like almost. And it's just like kept in the dark for sure. Could have been a storage spot. I don't know. Servant could have lived here. Maid. Gotta be. Nothing really to show though. Does it keep going? Can we exceed and go even further than beyond? Dude, that leads to another part of the house? It might. We gotta check that out. We'll go up later. Let me see what else is around here. There could be a lot of cool, interesting things under these boxes, though. Or it could be absolutely nothing. Let's see what we can find. I like old little knickknacks and things, like, for real. I don't know what these are. Oh, auction bridge, 100 sheets. Looking around. Nothing's catching my attention that I can physically see. I think this leads into the basement, but I'm freaked out. There's a freaking spider next to me. Okay, hang on. Oh! Oh, my light died! Oh! We can't go in the basement yet! No, I need my light, though, to film and take photos. Oh, man. This is not good. Okay, I killed a spider, I think. Alright, it's on the ground. Let's get out of here. I can't. Bro! My light died! Bro, my light died! No!
Oh, that's where you are.
My light died! Your light still works!
Dude, I thought you were up here!
You did?
Yeah!
Bro, I went to a secret side of the room!
What?
Come, yo, you wanna see it?
Yeah!
Yo, I have to come up with you just to see the attic now.
Oh, I'm not going in there.
Okay, maybe I'll go up there after. There's well, at least your spiders. Light works. Your light works. I'll need it after now. Now I can't. Dude, how did my light die? Dude, look, it just extends. It keeps going down to more rooms.
Dude, yeah, I was walking down here earlier and it kind of like tripped me out because I came in here. I thought this was going to be the last bedroom.
Yeah, same.
And it was like, no, there's more. I was like, shit.
Well, I've already explored it, but it leads into the basement. But, I mean, I don't have a light now, so I don't know. Do you want to go together, bro?
Maybe we should do it now.
Yeah, just.
And then I can show you guys the first floor.
Okay, oh yeah, you never saw. Oh, dude, they're in for a treat.
Heck yeah.
They're in for a treat.
All right, let's go. Let me show you where it is, and I'll let you go first, okay? Because you have the light, that's why.
There's oh, no, I see what you wanted
there's
to
no
do.
Other reason. It's just you have a light.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Right. Right here.
Oh, no. I'm so afraid.
See?
Just you're down really going to make me go first?
Mm-hmm. Don't worry.
What if I give you my light?
I already have a light on my tripod. You see the?
It was worth a try. Oh god damn it!
Don't worry, bro. I'll be right here.
Oh, I almost fell. Okay, let's give it a shot.
Okay.
It's all or nothing. Oh. Dude, what if the vultures migrated to the basement?
I don't think so. They don't want that.
I don't want it either.
Me either. I'm just following you from the back.
What if I see an animal?
Then we're gonna run.
I'm gonna freaking die.
Dude, look how this is small down
this
here.
This is really small. I'm getting cramped right now.
Me too.
Okay, I see a furnace heater.
Okay.
That's a good sign. That's like really old right there. It's cast iron too. Oh, there's a retro fridge right in front of us.
Wait, so we're not in the basement?
No, dude. It's like a kitchen.
Oh, I was here.
Oh, this is just the first floor.
Yeah, I was here already.
Oh, okay. I thought this was the basement. I was like, yo, they can.
Dude, I thought there was another way into the basement.
Okay,
this house is a maze.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, should we try again and go to the basement then?
Yeah, let's actually go to the basement.
All right, that's over here.
Let's give this a shot.
All right, here we go again. Take two, the basement.
Did you guys go in the basement yet?
Beth did.
Yeah, I did.
Is it scary?
You'll see.
All right, that's not promising, but all right. Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Oh, fuck that. There's a spider cricket right there. I'm not fucking going down there. Hell no.
Oh, man. Okay, guys, because that's why we sent Beth down. I was hoping it moved. See, we can't go in the basement. It's done. What is that?
Spider crickets.
In a jar?
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute.
There's a few alive.
Oh! Oh!
It's alive!
Oh, my God.
Why are they in there? Why are they in there?
Why are they alive?
They're pets.
Yo!
Dude, who put them in there? Get out! Yo, Beth, chill!
Chill,
yo!
Oh, it's jumping!
Stop! So, Seth was nice enough to give us his light so we can finish up this video. I just spent a lot of time taking photos. It's been about 30 minutes since the last shot. Now we're at bedroom number 3. Now, bedroom number 3, there's not too much going on here. It's not set up all the way. It's kind of messy. But I really do like the chair, and I like the cool shoes down there. What is this? Fire, panic, medical. It's like an old safe, maybe? An old alarm. I don't know what that is. You got a cool barrel, though. I mean, there's not too much left. You know, a house is a house. It's dope because you get to see all the old furniture and all the things that you might have missed back in your day of living on that just been, you know, obsolete now. You find all the cool stuff, but we're gonna end it by going into the attic. Let's get it. It's hot. Just gotta watch out for maybe vultures. Again, I've been hearing so much rumors that there's so much vultures here. Every time I go in attics, again, I bring this up a lot, but I always think of Sinister. I always think, like, this is it. Or The Grudge. Let's snoop around. It's actually really hot up here. I'm not seeing too much. There's really not much here. Why is this side blocked off, though? Tuberculosis. That's how you know this is an old spot. Home hygiene, care of the sick. How do you even get here? There's another way to the attic over there. I've never even seen it. Oh, I did. I think I did. I don't know. When I think of the attic, so I always think, like, maybe there's, like, a loose board. And in the loose board, like, you might find some, like, crazy good, I don't know, jewelry, diamonds, gems, you know what I mean? Creepy, like really crazy stuff.
Yerp, okay. Oh, we are now officially done exploring this house. Like I said, it's definitely a time capsule. There's so much stuff inside. It's full of mysteries. We don't know anything about the other people that lived in the house except the actual owner itself. We don't really know if they had a wife. We don't really know if they had kids. It's really hard to say, but there's a lot going on in there. It's pristine condition. There's a lot of great photo opportunities. The whole house is amazing. It is a gem. We're gonna end the video here. I'm gonna try to get some pho. Is that happening? Maybe?
Better happen.
We're gonna see. We don't know what we're gonna eat, but every time we're done exploring, we always feast and get something great. We're on a road trip, so I'm ending it here, guys. Rise above, just go out there and explore. Peace and thanks for watching.